Good morning, Huskies. I'm Bailey Moore.
And I'm her co-host, Isla Gordon.
I think we should start this episode off with some Black history. After all, it's still Black History Month.
Back when it was first created in 1926, Black History Month was actually only a week long.
50 years later, it became what it is today, and the month of February was chosen since it coincided with the birthdays of Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln.
And there are so many Black activists that rarely get their credit, like Claudette Colvin, who refused to give up her bus seat to white passengers 9 months prior to Rosa Parks.
But every activist was equally important in the civil rights movement, and so is every person still fighting for a brighter future today.
Well said.
Thanks. It's important to continue to educate yourself, even when this month ends.
An important way to do that is through reading books by abolitionist authors.
I'm sure you can find more at the bookstore.
But which one?
Well, Malia has a good suggestion in the newest Husky Hotspots.
Let's check it out.
Well, we just celebrated our 20th anniversary in July. We opened on July 26, 2003. We've expanded twice in our 20-year history, largely because of the support of Oak Park and how great Oak Parkers are. So we sort of started with a smaller niche of used and bargain books for the most part. And as demand grew, we started stocking more new books. The bookstore has sort of changed based on what our customers have asked of us over the years. As things have changed over time, we've had to add on staff, and we've tried to keep the same sort of mom and pop small business vibe.
Like a cool place.
Husky Hotspots. That reminds me of something else hot.
You mean hot takes?
How did you know?
It's in the script.
Then let's roll it. This week's topic, hot takes about music.
What's your music hot take?
Lana over Taylor.
Yeah! Oh God, want you on my lips. It's me, little Venice.
I don't like Harry Styles at all.
I agree.
Kanye West is never going to drop Vultures, and nobody's going to like him anymore.
Taylor Swift is not a good artist.
The sitar music is the most incredible meditative music to listen to calm the soul, to raise the spirits, to focus the mind.
Thank you.
Who am I here with?
Keith. Rod Wave is extremely overrated.
We don't think Taylor Swift should have won Album of the Year.
We think that it should have been SZA or Lana.
I don't like any music that don't uplift a student or a person or tap into their spirit and their soul, because our heartbeat is a drum.
It's really insightful. Thank you.
I don't think the Grammy was stolen from Travis Scott.
What's your name?
Bailey.
What's a hot take you have about music?
I hate Drake.
The Life of Pablo is Kanye's best album.
What's the deal with Taylor Swift? I don't get it.
Do you not like her music?
Not really.
I do not like Beyonce. I don't. Her voice all sounds the same to me. I know people aren't going to like it, but I'll fight till the end. No Beyonce for me.
No words appear before me in the aftermath.
You guys did not disappoint.
Those are some interesting takes, but I didn't agree with all of them.
Oh, but we missed someone's music opinion.
Oh, right. Carter, I let him take over Hymns of Life today. Let's hear it.
What's up, guys? Bailey gave me the opportunity to do a Hymns of Life segment, so I took it. This month, Black History Month, we're highlighting Bob Marley. In theaters now is One Love, a movie about Bob Marley, highlighting and celebrating all of his achievements throughout his life. What you're listening to right now is Turn Your Lights Down Low by Bob Marley. I like it because it's not one of his most popular songs, and it's got a nice beat. Take a listen.
I think that's all we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this week's New Scene, Huskies.
For all the things we weren't able to cover, from empty bowls to book club, don't forget to read your daily bulletin located in your student email. We'll see you next time.
Bye. Bye.